Hello everyone. It's January 15th, 3 p.m. A cold 1 degree, feels like minus one. I'm at the corner of Kemp Road and Young Street. And today we're going to take a walk of Kemp Road because I have never covered that part of the city before. And there's a lot of growth happened out there, like a lot of car dealerships and things like that, and stuff went up, and fast food places and all that. So today we're going to walk right out Kemp Road and take a good look at what all's out there. So let's get ready. When this light turns, we'll go on our journey. Hopefully you enjoy this video today, a little something different from what I've been doing. We are in the north end of Halifax. We cover a lot of things in the north end, but never went out Kemp Road. Well, it's a little bit cold today, but I've got my hood up, and my gloves on, and my toque on, my Toronto Maple Leaf toque. So I think I'm good. It's a little windy, but I got my microphone plugged in. Now I just gotta remember to keep my voice down, because if I talk too loud, I'll overload it. I'm trying to get better at that. I think when I started out, I might talk too loud. But I'll try to keep that in mind and not do that. There we go. Straightened up my picture just a little bit. So this is a whole different area out here. This is like a load of car dealerships and other things too. Duties is right there. And I'm just passing a plaza right here, and this Dollarama is just like the store next to the street, but there's a lot of stores in that plaza, which I might have touched on that before a little bit. So, we're going out here. That's Nissan. Nissan dealership right there. Nissan Infiniti. And just across the road, we have Kia. I think it's Kia. Let's have a look. I saw some Kia cars back there, but they could be used ones. I think it's Nissan as well. I don't know. These are all the used cars. So, let's see if we can tell what dealership that is. That could be just belonging to that one across the street, probably. Because I don't see where it'd be. Belong to anybody else here, so it probably belongs to that one. But there's a whole bunch of car dealerships out here. This is O'Regan's Nissan. And I presume both ones are the same company. And over here we got lots of trade-ins. These aren't brand new cars, but some of them are. Don't think I'll be buying one of those $47,000 ones very soon. A little bit out of my price range. So there's a new building right over there. It's gone up, and it looks to me, I could be wrong, but it looks to me like that's a parking garage, or it's going to be an indoor dealership, big dealership showroom. I'm thinking it might be that, but it might be a parking garage. One or the other, but it doesn't look like anything else. There's Jaguar Land Rover right there. There's many, many car dealerships up here. That looks like a fairly new building right there too. So we'll just try to give you a look at everything that's out here. You can Apple Auto Glass is back in there. The signs right there, but they're back in there. And, Chef Abbott Cafe and Catering right there. It's a nice little walk out here today. It's a little cool, but I don't really mind it because I'm dressed for it. I'm dressed for the cold weather. And if you dress for the cold weather, it don't fly to you. So here's another O'Regan National Leasing Car and Truck Rentals. You can lease a car there or rent a car. And there's a place that specializes in cleaning cars. Yeah, that looks like a car parking garage up there. Because it couldn't be anything else but those open kind of bars up there. I don't know, it's hard to say. Unless they're going to fill those in. But that's what it looks like. Looks like a car parking garage. But maybe not. Time will tell. So here we have, it's like O'Regan's own most of the car dealerships. That's O'Regan's BMWs and Minis, which have the same Minis made with BMW. So BMW and Mini is right here. Well, you be the judge, whatever you think that building right there might be. Looks like a car parking garage, but I could be wrong. I hope my voice isn't too loud for that microphone, because it's really bad if I speak too loud and overload it, and then it's noisy. So I'm trying to get better at it. I'll try not to talk loud. Keep my voice down. Remember, that microphone is strong, and it has a place because it protects you from the wind. Don't make a racket in the microphone. But I guess it's made so you can put it under your nose and you can still hear. So it picks up your voice like really, really loud. So I have to talk really low in order for that to work. I should be on the other side of the road because the sidewalk's over there. I'm going to try to cross the road if I can without getting run over. Because it's a busy spot here right now. And I'm going to try. Not too far as I get by. I'll let that one go over. And maybe I can make it. Another one. I think I can make it. Okay. I'm over here now. Sidewalk is a lot better to walk on than over there because there's no sidewalk. And you just walk it over the grass. And there's some soggy spots. And sidewalk much better. And there's another car dealership here. This is Audi Halifax. They don't say O'Regan, so maybe they don't own this one. It's possible that it's owned by someone else. We got Audi Halifax. And they make nice cars. There's a Jaguar, I think it's Audi. Audi, I think a Jaguar Land Rover, yeah. They're out of my price range. Well, there's the Audi dealer. And over here is Kia. Kia right over there. They got so many other things. No matter what kind of car you want to buy, you can find it right here on Kemp Road. They've got everything. I think almost every dealer, every kind of car is covered here. And Kia is O'Regan. Now whether there's a whole bunch of O'Regan brothers that own these or if it's one guy, I don't know. But they're making the money. There's a new building going up. That's probably a car dealership place, no doubt. Well, there's lots of interesting things out here on Kemp Road. And unless you work over in this area, well, you have some business here, you probably wouldn't even pay much attention to Kemp Road. Because unless you have some reason to travel over it. It's just one of those streets that, well, it's a through street, but yet you'd probably take Roby if you were going anywhere. You wouldn't really take Kemp Road. Just show you everything that's on it here. There's a horse dealer. And like I told you, there's every brand of car on Kemp Road, and they're all in a row. There's your Porsche. And right next door is Halifax Volvo. There's so many choices right here. There's a Porsche. They're very expensive cars. I won't think I'll be ever shopping for a Porsche or a Volvo. I'll stick to the cheaper brands. Not that I wouldn't like a Porsche, but I don't think that's for me. So anyway, we'll continue on down here. And I see Enterprise Car Rentals is down here. And there's some of these little industrial units like that are along here too. There's a textile place, residential, commercial, industrial, marine fabric products. And I see a husky coming here. One of my favorite dogs is husky. They're really nice dogs. Hi. He wanted to smell my glove. My stepson up in Ontario has a husky. They're quite frisky dogs, but they're very inquisitive. But they make great pets. They're very loyal to their owners, and they're quite rambunctious with their great pets. For anybody looking for a pet, if you've got time to babysit your dog, a husky might be right for you. If you have to leave it alone all day, don't get a husky, because they don't like to be left alone. And you might come home to find your couch has been chewed up or something if you leave it alone. So they're, but they are a great pet. They love them all. They're frisky. They love going out in the snow in the winter. And that's the one thing about a husky. They won't bother them. They go out to go out in the snow. You can take it out walking with you in the wintertime, and they love it. I was half thinking about that, but where we live right now, we can't have dogs. So we have to be content with our little cat. They allow cats, but they don't allow dogs. So dogs are out for now. Maybe one day I'll have myself a dog, but not right at the moment. When we were up in Ontario, we were both working, and no time for pets. We had a cat, because you can leave him alone all day and don't mind wanting to take care of him when you get home. But dogs, you need a little more attention, so we were too busy working to have a dog. Now I got time, but can't have one where I live. So those are the choices we have to make. You gotta live somewhere, and not every place wants you to have a dog. So you have to, you can't be too fussy where you live, because you might, you know, they're getting more scarce all the time, because a lot of people are moving in here. And apartments are rising. I say it, when you're scarce, they cost more. And you can't really tell them what you want. You gotta do pretty much what they say. So anyways, still on Kemp Road. Swiss Chalet is right there. Harvey's is right there. And McDonald's is right there. We got three fast food places right below. And this is not a long way from Yonge Street. This is just, if I was walking this, it's just up around that turn, top of the hill. And you're at Yonge Street, so it's not that far. I think I stopped talking about McDonald's, 24 hours. Yeah, another drive-through, 24-hour drive-through. So I'll just stand here, let that car go by that's here, and I will hold them up. Here's another O'Regan's dealership. They sell Lexus, Toyota and Lexus. The Toyota's dealership, I would say too. I see you got some Mercedes-Benz that's traded in there and all kinds of things. Jesus. There's Speedy Autographs right over there. There's a lot of stuff on the street. A lot more than you'd realize. If you're just driving through here to get to someplace, you might not realize there's that much stuff here, but there's a lot of things. OK Tires right over there. A well-known tire brand in Halifax and many other cities too, but it's OK Tires. Which does, I don't know about this one, it's just a small one. Some of them do truck tires too. And it looks like some just do cars. But they do have one large bay there, so chances are you might take care of you if your truck had a flat tire or needed tires. Well, there's the Lexus dealer. Toyota Lexus. You got a big yard here full of cars. Dry cleaners right there. And that looks like a service garage. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 bays. Well, we'll continue on. Wendy's is out here. So we got an awful lot of fast food places out here. But, the wind's blowing now. I'm glad I used my microphone because the wind is really blowing now. So hopefully it doesn't pick up anything from the wind. I don't think it does. I got it inside my jacket. I got an inside pocket in my jacket. Microphone in there, put it to the top of my inside pocket and close my jacket up. And I have all the confidence in the world that it can hear me while I'm talking. Yeah, but I'm not peeking, so it should be all right. There's a little meter on my screen there and I'm just watching it while I'm talking. And it don't seem to be peeking, so it should be okay. If it goes right up to the top, it's going to be a little bit distorted. Because I overloaded, gotta be careful of that. I've been into Wendy's before over here, and I've been into McDonald's, and haven't been to Swiss Chalet. Though I've been to Swiss Chalet quite often, but not this one, because we usually go over in darkness, because that's what we do. So there's the Mercedes-Benz dealer, which is O'Regan's again. So they pretty much control the car market here in Halifax, I would say. Not everything comes from O'Regan's, but we didn't get our car there from O'Regan's, but who knows? Maybe next one, don't know. Hard to say. There's a hall where you can have events. It looks like they have a furniture showroom sometimes in there. It's almost time for furniture shows. They usually do them in the spring. They start, there's usually still some snow on when they start the furniture event because they want people to see what's out there. And, the dealers usually come to the furniture shows too. And they see what the factories are putting out and get ready to place their orders. I worked in that business up in Ontario. Our main customer was Sealy Mattresses. We hauled mattresses out of Sealy because I was a truck driver and I went to a lot of the furniture shows too that they were putting the display on. Like Sealy would have quite a large display. We used to go to the International Center on Airport Road in Toronto. Every year it was about maybe March. Then the February or March, somewhere around there. when they started having those, get ready for the furniture shows, and then there'd be different ones around in the city, different places. So we'd have a big area. It usually took us 2 trailer loads for the furniture show. And we took them up there, and usually last about 3 days. Then we'd come back and get them again and bring them back. A lot of the props we took to a storage place, and mattresses came back to see them. Unless the furniture dealer bought a whole bunch, sometimes they take a whole trailer load right from the show, right from the furniture show. Yeah, they wouldn't even have to take it back, and take it right to their store. Sometimes that happens. Anyway, enough about furniture shows. Here's Mitsubishi Motors, and CarQuest is right over here. No, you won't be disappointed on Kemp Road if you're looking for a car. There's Mitsubishi, and just down the road is Subaru. There is definitely a lot of car dealerships down here. I'm not sure where I'm going to end this video because I've been at it now 24 minutes. I'm good for quite a while yet. So we'll see what happens when we get down here to the end of where I can walk and get out. I try not to jiggle my phone around too much here. I know that's annoying if you see a video and it's jumping all over the place. So I'm going to try just changing hands here. Try to keep it smooth if I can. Yeah. I see some flashing police car lights down here. I'm not sure if there's been a fender bender or something, more than likely. See some traffic backed up right here now. But we'll get down there. Maybe it'll still be there. Whoops. Sorry. I was doing something. Hit my phone. Alright, yeah, we'll see what this is down here when we get here. It looks like a fender bender in an intersection. Well, we'll see. Well, there's your Subaru dealership. Now we're going to get down here to see what this was. See what happened here. I'll be the roving reporter today and report on this car crash. Still here when I get down here. I don't see a tow truck, a police car. But I better stick to the sidewalk because we are getting into rush hour now. I better stick to the sidewalk. Looks like the end of the car dealership. Subaru is the last one on the list here on Kemp Road. So that's our dealership tour. Now we'll just walk over here. I hear a siren or something coming. An ambulance is coming now to that accident scene. So we will try to go across here if we can. If I don't get run over to the intersection, that'll be great. So, I'll stay my distance. We'll go down on this side. Oh, there's a Ford dealership right here. We hadn't seen Ford yet. There it is, Ford dealership right there. So I think we got them all covered. Chevrolet, Ford. Haven't seen Dodge. That's the only one I haven't seen down there. But no doubt they're here somewhere. So there's your Ford dealership. So this has been a car buyer's guide today. If you're looking for a new car, Kemp Road in Halifax. Got a dealership for just about any kind of car you want to buy. It's just like cruising through a supermarket and picking out your items. You can drive down the street and pick out your car. Yeah, so something happened over here. There's an ambulance and some people gathered there. I hope nobody got stuck on the crosswalk. It looks like they're looking at something there on the ground. We will see. up over here. I can't cross the street here because there's no crosswalk. So we'll just stand over here and see what this is. It don't look like a car crash because, oh, there's another car up there with a four ways on, I think. It might be. Put somebody in the ambulance. It could be someone got struck there. Possibly. Yep, it does look that way, like a car could have hit it by something. This is a busy intersection right here. And people are hurrying to get home from working all day. And you gotta be careful. The person is conscious, I think, because it's kind of sitting up. Yeah, they're sitting up in the... I think they're sitting up. Well, anyways, that's that. We'll go back around here. My gimbal is turned on me for some reason here. Try to get that straightened up. There we go. Everything's back now. Sometimes in the cold weather it likes to do that. So we can't go much farther down this way. So we're going to go back the way we came, I guess. We're right beside the highway here now. If you're going to Dartmouth, you can get on the... I think it's the 111 there for Dartmouth. And if you go up, I guess going towards Troll, you get on the 118, I believe that's what it is. There's a lot of highways here. I haven't learned the names of them all yet, but I believe that's how it goes. I see Mighty Auto is back in there. That's a good store. You need to buy things for your car. And did you work on your cars as well? So, let's see. I can't go straight because you have to use the crosswalk, sir. Can't go down that way. Have to take the crosswalk. Okay, somebody's stopping for me, so I'll walk across. That was great. Now, we'll go up across this one, it stays green, we'll make this, and then we'll start back to the road, I guess. We may take a different route, though, just to make this interesting. Might do that. I've showed you all the car dealerships on Kemp Road. Saw an accident over on the corner. And there's Q104's headquarters right there. And Subway's over there. So, I think we just about covered this area up here. Kilm Apartment Rentals has got an office here. This is probably the... I can't say it's their head office, but it might be because there's no apartment buildings here and they got an office here, so chances are that's their head office. Kemp Road. Anybody looking for a Kilm apartment? It's on Kemp Road, quite close to the highway. They own a lot of properties in Halifax. So if you're new to Halifax and you're looking for an apartment, Kilm is probably your best option because they own the most buildings. And I would say they're a reputable company because when we moved to Halifax, we lived in Toronto, and we sent our deposit about a month ahead of time before we come down. And we moved down here, went to the office and moved right in and you know, paid what we had to pay, but there wasn't no glitches. It went through. We just moved right in, and so Kilm is a good place. If you're living in Ontario and you're thinking about coming down here, you can take my word for it. They're a reputable firm. You can send your money in ahead, and you'll get here, and you'll get into your apartment, and you won't have any trouble. So Kilm Apartment Rentals is a good company. That's all I can say about that. I've heard some horror stories about people moving here to Halifax. And when they get here, the price they were quoted is not the price they had to pay, and it was really high. And sometimes the buildings were in bad shape, and there was all kinds of issues. And but Kilm's not like that. Kilm's a good company to deal with. Enough said about that. But I try to be helpful in any way I can, because Halifax is a nice place, and you don't want to get off on the wrong foot when you get into a strange place and you don't know things, how things work, and you don't know too many people. So it's nice if you can get off on the right footing when you move here. You don't have some issues like that with your housing and things. So I gotta just tell you, my experience went good. We moved down here 2.5 years ago and moved right into our place. And we're still there. And they take care of us when we go to the office. Usually they get right on it. Once in a while, it takes a day or two. But if there's something that's wrong or something burned out or something quit working. I was really happy the other day. I got to pass this on. Our smoke alarms in our building are all hooked together, so if one goes off, they'll all go off and they'll know something's up. So anyways, our smoke alarm started going off in the night for no reason, and so I went down to the office yesterday, and before the day was over, the guy was there to fix it and change that unit and put a new one in there, and now everything's good. No more beeping in the middle of the night. So it didn't take a month of hollering about it. They just took care of it. So good for them. Another thing that might give you trouble in Halifax is finding a good mechanic, because there are some shops here. There's one that I dealt with, and I wouldn't recommend that. I won't say who it is. Let's put it this way, they're on Roby Street. When we first came here, it's a large chain. They had them in Ontario as well. And that's where we got all our work done, in Ontario. They were really good. They used us good, treated us right. So when we came to Halifax, we just gravitated towards that same company. And I had a really bad experience one day. I took our car in there, and I was spending quite a bit of money. I was getting a complete brake job, four wheels, and that included the brake discs and the pads and brake cylinders and all kinds of stuff. But put a brand new set of brakes all the way around it. it was more than $1,000. It was probably, I think if I remember right, it was about $1,200 or $1,300 I spent on the car that day. And the way they do it in this particular shop, the mechanic, when he's done with your car, they'll take it off the hoist, put it outside, and he'll bring the bill in to the guy behind the desk. I saw him take the car out and park it, and I saw him bring the bill in. And the guy sat right there and never told me, and I was sitting there. So I walked up and asked the guy, I said, "Is that my bill there? I need to go." He said, "Why don't you have a seat over there and I'll call you when I'm ready." And he had no other customers. So I thought that was like really rude. I said, "I guess he don't value my business here." And so we've got a lot of work done since then at other places. And they lost their business. I will never be back in that shop. I won't name who they are because I just, you know, it's old news now. That was over a year ago. Where I go now, they treat me good. I showed you the garage in one of my videos. I think it was the last video in the South End. I showed you the garage. And I would highly recommend those people. They do a great job on my car. It don't matter what is wrong. I know they'll fix it right. And it'll be good when it comes out. And they usually be good on the price. The price is reasonable. I know nothing's cheap today, but the price is reasonable there. And I haven't got any complaints of the highest price for that garage. So if you come to Halifax, you're looking for a garage, don't just settle on the first one that fixes your car, because they might turn out to be not so good. Or they might be good. They might turn out to be good. But once you find one, I stick with that one, and it's my experience, if you stick with the same place, they look after you pretty good when you go in. If you go all over the place, this one time, this one, then they treat you like a new person, and we'll take care of our good customers first, and we'll get to you after. But if you stick with the same one, everything will go smooth. So that's my experience with cars and mechanics here. Had my little rant about that. So anyway, we're walking back on Kemp Road towards Young and Roby, which I plan to stop this video maybe even before that. I'm already up to 20 almost for 25 minutes maybe into this video. I don't want to make them too long because people get bored. And so that's what we do. We're making our way back up to the corner there. I call it the corner, Young and Roby. One of the busiest intersections in the city of Halifax, Young and Roby. And there's a truck, it's not a truck stop, but a lot of trucks come in there and park. And there's gas pumps and Tim Hortons and Coast Tires there. And it's very busy. So, anyways, right now, I'm just waiting to get through this intersection because it's very busy here, and gotta watch out for cars. Okay. Go right across, make sure nobody, I don't want one of those people to get hit in the intersection. Okay. Get through here. And somewhere soon I'm gonna end this video because I've showed you everything coming down here. There's not a whole lot left to show. So maybe we'll just stop right here where you can see McDonald's, Harvey's, and the Swiss Chalet, all right in a row, just before the little cranes up here. And we'll stop right there, and this video's been going at least half an hour. So hope you didn't get too bored and you enjoyed this video. And as always, if you like this video, don't forget that like and subscribe button. And we'll try to get some more good videos out for you soon too, okay? Have a good day. Bye for now.